Brahmine. Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavan Ebyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. We're hearing about the great battle between Indra and Vritasura, as described in the sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter number 12.
我们在聆听的是一场伟大的战斗，这个是Indra和Vritasura之间的这场战斗，这被描述在圣典《薄伽瓦坛》第六篇的第十二章。
Indra had a weapon which was given to him, which was made for him from the bones of a great yogi called Dadichi.
Indra 有一个非常很有力量的武器，这个武器是用一个伟大的瑜伽师，有力量的瑜伽师 Dadichi 的骨头制成的。
And Lord Narayan had told him that weapon would be able to kill the demon Vritasura.
主Narayana告诉他们，用这个武器可以杀死恶魔Vritasura。
Indra was surprised that Vritasura was actually a devotee in the body of a demon.
Indra 其实非常的惊讶，这一个有恶魔般躯体的人，竟然他是一个奉献者。
So in the course of their battle, Indra cut off both the arms of Vritasura.
在这场战斗的时候， Indra 砍掉了Vritasura的两只手臂。
So Vritasura was very powerful, and he had great physical strength, and his body was huge. He was very gigantic size.
Vritasura非常有力量，而且身体非常的大，他的躯体和他的整个躯体就是超乎寻常的大。
So he put his lower jaw on the ground, and he opened his mouth, and he swallowed Indra.
他张开他的嘴，底下就是下颚顶在地面上，然后吞掉了，把Indra给吞噬下去。He had
no arms, so it was very difficult for him to fight Indra. So he used his yoga powers. By his yoga powers, he could take this huge form, gigantic size, and he just came before Indra, and he swallowed not only Indra, but he also swallowed the elephant carrier of Indra, Airavata.
因为Vritasura这个时候已经没有手臂了，他无法正常的跟Indra进行战斗，于是呢，他用他的瑜伽的玄秘力量，以及他巨大的身体，他来到面前，不仅来到Indra的面前，不仅吞噬了Indra，还把Indra的坐骑 Airavata 这头大象也给吞噬了。Just
like sometimes a big python, big pythons, they sometimes swallow elephants.
就像有的时候有一条巨大的蟒蛇，我们称它为巨蟒，这个巨蟒有时候也能够吞噬一头大象。
So the demigods, along with Brahma and the other residents in the higher planets, they were all watching this fight between Vritasura and Indra.
这些随行的半神们，他们还有这些恶魔，他们都在看Indra和半神人，Indra和Vritasura之间的这场战斗。
And when they saw that Indra was swallowed by the demon Vritasura, then they were very shocked.
当他们看到Indra被Vritasura给吞掉了之后，他们非常的震惊。
They became very sad, and they said, "Oh, alas, what a calamity, what a calamity!"
他们看到 Indra 被吞，被恶魔所吞了之后，不禁非常的郁闷悲尽，惊叹起来，他说，哦，阿拉斯，这是怎样的灾难？这发生了什么样的灾难？
However, Indra had a special protective armor of Lord Narayan.
然而 ，Indra 他也有一个很特别的保护他自己的盔甲。
And that armor was not different from Lord Narayan himself.
这个盔甲与至尊人格守神拿尔央呢也是没有区别的。
So although Indra was swallowed into the body of Vritasura, the armor and his mystic power protected him.
即便 Indra 被 Vritasura 给吞掉了，但是这个盔甲仍然保护着 Indra。
Even though he was in the body of the demon, he was in the demon's belly, he stayed alive.
即便他在恶魔的躯体里，在恶魔的肚腹之中，他仍然还存活着。
And he had also his thunderbolt weapon with him, which was very powerful.
而且他还随身携带着自己的霹雳的这个武器，这个霹雳还非常有力量。
So with his thunderbolt weapon, from inside the belly of demon Vritasura, he began to cut out his way out of the belly.
因着用他强悍有力的霹雳把Vritasura 的肚子肚腹给切了。
Indra was actually a powerful warrior. He'd already killed demons before. He killed one demon called Bala.
Indra 也是一个非常有力量的人，他在之前还杀掉了一个恶魔，这个恶魔名字叫 Bala。
So Indra cut his way out of the belly of Vritasura.And then he cut off Vritasura's head.
这个时候 ，Indra 他杀掉了，他切掉了 Vritasura， 切掉了 Vritasura 的头颅。
And actually, his head was as high, it was as high as the peak of a mountain.
而 Vritasura 的头甚至和一座山那样高。
So although the thunderbolt was revolving around Vritasura's neck, in order to cut off his head, that thunderbolt of Indra had to revolve around the neck of Vritasura.
为了砍下 Vritasura 的头颅 ，Indra 用他的霹雳以极快的速度去环绕着 Vritasura 的脖子。
It was going at a very high speed and it cut through the body, cut through the head, but it took 1 year to cut through the body, to get the head off, to separate the head from the body. It took a whole year.
虽然这个霹雳旋转围绕着他的脖子旋转的速度非常的快，但是仍然这个霹雳花了一年的时间才把 Vritasura 的头给切了下来。
Yeah, it took 360 days.
花了360天的时间。
That is the time which it takes for the sun and the moon and all the other stars and planets in the sky to go on a complete journey.
这是太阳、月亮以及其他发光体完成南北南线和就是说他们就是南北回归线环绕所就是所需要的时间。
So then it was at the suitable time for Vritasura to be killed. That's when his head fell to the ground. They waited for the suitable time. There's a special time when it was good for Vritasura to die. And that's when his head fell off and fell to the ground.
他们之所以花这么长时间也是在等待一个恰当的时间，等待这个 Vritasura 他应该要死的恰当的时间。然后在那个恰当的时间的时候，他的头掉落到地面上。
Just like in the very first canto, we heard about Grandfather Bhishma leaving the body.
就像在先前的第一篇，我们听到祖父毕什玛他离开躯体的时候。
Yeah, Bhishma was waiting for the auspicious time to leave the body.
祖父 Bhishma 也在等待一个吉祥的时间离开躯体。
Bhishma, grandfather Bhishma, he had a benediction from his father that he could live as long as he wanted to live, and whenever he wanted to leave the body, that's when he would leave. He had that benediction that he could decide when he wanted to leave the body.
祖父毕什玛从他的父亲那里得到了一个祝福，就是说当他想要离开的时候，他就可以离开这个躯体，就是说他可以选择他自己想要的时间离开这个躯体。
So the same the Vritta Sura, he was also, he had some kind of power that he could decide when to was going to leave the body.
Vritta Sura, 他也可以，就是说他可以选择自己想要的时间离开躯体，哦不，他也可以在恰当的时间离开躯体。
So when Vritasura was killed, then the Gandharvas and the Siddhas in the heavenly planets, they started to beat their drums and they were all very excited.
当 Vritasura 被杀掉的时候，天堂星宿的 Gandharva 和 Siddha 他们都非常的兴奋。都开始敲锣打鼓。
And they began to chant Vedic hymns to celebrate the victory of Indra.
他们准备开始唱诵伟达赞歌，以庆祝 Vritasura 的死。
And they praised Indra and they threw flowers upon him very happily.
他们赞扬 Indra， 然后给 Indra 抛花。
And they were glorifying Indra as the killer of Vritasura.
他们荣耀 Indra， 他们说你是 Vritasura 的屠者。
So Sukadeva Goswami describes to Maharaj Parikshit, he says that the spiritual spark then came out from Vritasura's body and it went back home, back to Godhead.
Sukadeva Goswami 这个时候就说，就对 Parikshit Maharaj 说，这个时候Vritasura 的生命火花从他的躯体中出来了，然后重返家园。
And all the demigods were watching, and they could see the spirit soul leave and entered into the spiritual world, and it went there to become an associate of Lord Sankarshan.
所有的半神人都观看了这一幕，他们看到这个离性的灵魂从他的躯体出来，然后进入超然的世界。成为了主山卡上的一位同友。
Right, before Chitraketu, before Vritasura, Vritasura in his previous life had been Chitraketu, and at that time he'd been a devotee of Lord Sankarshan.
在 Vritasura 的前一世，他是 Chitraketu， 而 Chitraketu 他是主山卡上的一位奉献者。
So now, when his demon body has been killed. He's able to go back to Godhead to be with Lord Sankarshan and to be an associate of Lord Sankarshan.
当 Vritasura 被杀了之后，这个时候他就灵魂出来，然后他可以进入到灵性世界，回归守身，成为主山卡山的一位同友。
Now, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has a very interesting commentary to explain about this.
Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur 对此有一段非常有意思的评注。
And he says that actually it was Indra who was killed, not Vritasura.
他说事实上是 Indra 真正被杀了，而不是 Vritasura 被杀了。
And he said when Vritasura swallowed Indra and the elephant as well, then at that time Vritasura thought, now I have killed Indra.
当 Vritasura 吞掉了 Indra 以及他的大象的时候，这个时候 Vritasura 就想，我已经杀掉了 Indra 了。
So Vritasura thought there's no more need to fight now.
Vritasura 于是就想，我现在就再也不需要战斗了。
And so Vritasura decided, let me go back to Godhead. Let me go back home, back to Godhead.
Vritasura 就想，那么现在让我。能够回归守神，回归家园吧。我现在就好好想一想这个事情。
So he stopped all of his bodily activities and he sat down in trance.
于是维车苏惹就坐了下来，他再也不做其他的事情，然后进入到神殿之中。
And he'd already swallowed Indra and the elephant, so it was very quiet. So Vritasura was just sitting there in samadhi, in trance.
维车苏惹已经吞掉的鹰爪和他的大象，于是这个时候周围也变得非常的安静，没有战斗了。于是他坐了下来，变得进入到神殿之中。
And because Vritasura was in trance, so Indra was able to come out from his belly.
由于 Vritasura 进入到神殿之中，这个时候鹰爪才可能从他的腹部之中出来。
So Vritasura was in yoga samadhi.
维车苏惹是处于瑜伽的神殿之中。
And Indra wanted to cut his throat. He wanted to cut off the demon's head.
而鹰爪想杀掉这个恶魔，想杀掉，砍断他的喉咙，砍断他的头颅。
But the demon's neck was so stiff that it took 360 days to cut through it.
但是这个恶魔的脖子是如此僵硬，以至于鹰爪花了整整360天才将它切了下来。
So Vritasura left the body. He left that body, and that body was cut to pieces by Indra.
维车苏惹离开了那个躯体，而那个躯体已经被鹰爪砍成了碎片。
But Vritasura was not cut. He was not cut. He was not killed.
但是维车苏惹实际上他没有被杀死，他也没有被砍成碎片。
No, it was only the body that Indra killed.
只是他的躯体被 Indra 给砍碎了。
But Vritasura himself, he was not killed.
维车苏惹本人，他这个灵性的，他自己没有被砍，没有被砍掉，没有被杀死。
And Vritasura, he went home back to Godhead.To be an associate of Lord Sankarsan.
而且维车苏惹他回归守神，回归家园，成为主山卡山的一位同友。
He went to Vaikuntha Loka, where Sankarsan resides eternally.
他去到 Vaikuntha Loka, 主山卡山永恒的居住在那。
So we'll go ahead to chapter 13, and we'll hear about Indra afflicted by sinful reactions.
我们现在将进入到第六篇的第十三章，这章将描述 Indra 是如何遭受折磨的。
Right, Indra had just killed Vritasura. Vritasura was the son of a Brahmana, and he was a great devotee.
Indra 刚刚杀死了一位恶魔，杀死了 Vritasura， 而 Vritasura 他是婆罗门之子，而且他还是一位伟大的奉献者。
So Sukadeva Goswami is telling Maharaj Parikshit, he said, when Vritasura was killed, all the deities and everyone in the three planets was very happy, and they thought, no more trouble.
Sukadeva Goswami 就跟 Parikshit Maharaj 说，当 Vritasura 被杀死的时候，所有主宰的神明以及三个世界内每一个人都欢欣不已。
They all thought, yeah, it's very good, no more trouble. Everyone thought like that except for Indra.
他们都非觉得，哎呀，现在太好了，而且已经摆脱了麻烦。但是呢，只有除了一个人，那个人就是 Indra.
Because Indra knows he was the one who killed the person, so he gets a reaction.
Indra 他知道他是那个杀死了。杀死了婆罗门的那维车苏惹那个人，他会受到报应。
So all of the different demigods who were under Indra, they all went back to their homes.
在场的所有的半神人，那些所有的天堂星宿的所有的半神人，他们都回到自己的各自返回自己的家中。
Even great demigods like Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva and Pitri Loka, people from Pitri Loka and Bhuta Loka, know, and the demons also, and the demigods, they all just went home.
有主 Brahma, 主 Shiva, 还有 Pitra Loka, Brahma Loka, 所有的这些人他们都各自返回各自的家里。
And they didn't even speak to Indra when they went home. They just went. They said, oh, good, and then they just went home.
他们甚至都没有跟 Indra 打一声招呼，然后就直接该走的时候就直接就走了。
So even Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, and the other demigods, they all went back to their residences, where they have their place, where they have their own residence.
主 Shiva, 主 Brahma, 还有那些居民们，他们都回到他们各自的家里去了。
But Indra, he couldn't do that because he was really, his mind was very disturbed because he knew he killed a Brahmana. He killed Vritasura, who was actually a Brahmana.
半神人都返回各自的居所，但是 Indra 没有，因为 Indra 他知道他这个是他内心非常的不安，因为他知道 Vritasura是一位 Brahmana， 而且他甚至还是一位奉献者。
So Indra went to Manasa Sarova Lake to get away from his sinful, to get free from his sinful reactions.
于是 Indra 就去了 Manasa Sarova 这个湖，他去那里去免除他的罪恶反应。
And when he left that lake, after leaving the Manasarova Lake, after purifying himself, then he went to do an Ashwamedha Yagya, and then he went home.
当他离开那个 Manasarova 的时候，他举行了一个 Ashwamedha 的这个马祭，然后之后再返回自己的家中。
So Maharaj Parikshit was puzzled when he heard this from Sukadeva Goswami.And he asked him, what was wrong? Why was Indra unhappy?
Maharaj Parikshit 听到这之后，他就问Sukadeva Goswami, 到底发生了什么事情？为什么 Indra 就不快乐呢？
Maharaj Parikshit said, I want to hear about this.
Maharaj Parikshit 就对 Sukadeva Goswami 说，我想聆听有关于这一点。
When Indra killed the demon Vritasura, the demigods were all very happy.Why was Indra not happy?
当 Indra 杀死了 Vritasura 之后，所有的半神都非常的快乐。但是为什么就是 Indra 不快乐呢？
So this is a very good question.
这是一个非常好的问题。
When a demon is killed, then of course all the demigods are happy.
当一个恶魔被杀掉的时候，理所当然的，所有的半神人都会高兴。
But in this particular case, when all the demigods were happy because of Vritasura having been killed, Indra was unhappy. Why?
但是在这个特别的案例之中，当众半神人因 Vritasura 而被杀感到高兴的时候，但是就是 Indra 不高兴，为什么呢？
So it might be.That Indra was unhappy because he knew that he had killed a great devotee and a brahmana.
可能是这样的 ，Indra 他知道自己杀害了一位伟大的奉献者和 brahmana， 所以他知道他杀害了奉献者和 brahmana， 他而变得不高兴。
Externally, it appeared like Vritasura was a demon.
外在的好像看 Vritasura 是一个恶魔
，but actually he was a great devotee and a good brahmana.
但是事实上，他是一位伟大的奉献者，他是一位婆罗门。
So we see sometimes people like Prahlad Maharaj and Bali Maharaj, externally they appear to be demons because they're born in the family of demons.
有一些时候，比如说像 Prahlada Maharaj 或者 Bali Maharaj， 他们外在的看上去是恶魔，因为他们或者说他们诞生于恶魔的家庭之中。
But actually, of course, neither of them are demons. They're both great devotees.
但是从内在来看， 他们都是伟大的奉献者，他们两个人都是伟大的奉献者。
So if we think of proper culture, so nobody should be considered a demon just on the basis of birth.
如果从真正文化的角度去看，没有人就是不应当从出生的考虑去考虑人是半神还是恶魔。
Yeah, and same way you don't know who's a demigod just by birth. You can't just look at the birth. You have to see the nature, the qualities of the person.
我们不能从出生去判断一个人到底是不是半神或恶魔，而得看他的本性，看他的真正的本性是怎么样。
So when he's fighting with Indra, Vridhasura showed he was a good devotee.
在于Indra 的交战之中， Vritrasura 证明了他自己是一个伟大的奉献者。
And as soon as he finished fighting with Indra and was apparently killed, then Vritrasura was transferred to Vaikuntha Loka.
当 Vritrasura 与 Indra 的这个战争一结束， Vritrasura 离开了躯体之后，他立马就被转移到了 Vaikuntha Loka。
And there he becomes an associate of Lord Sankarshan.
他到了维昆塔，成为了主桑卡山的永恒的朋友。
And Indra knew all this, and he knew that he killed a good devotee.
Indra 也知道了这一点，他知道他杀害了一个伟大的奉献者。
So Indra was feeling very guilty, felt very sad that he'd killed such a good devotee.
Indra 感觉到非常的惭愧，也非常的悲伤。他竟然非常的沮丧、悲伤。他竟然杀害了一位伟大的奉献者。
So somebody who is a Vaishnava is already a Brahmana.
一个人他如果是 Vaishnava 的话，他已经是一位婆罗门的。
But a Brahmana may not be a Vaishnava.
但是一个 Brahmana 他却不一定可能是 Vaishnava。
Someone may be a Brahmana in terms of his culture and his family.
有一些人成为 Brahmana 可能是根据某一种文化或者说他的家庭。
And he may be expert in Vedic knowledge.
或许他还非常精通于伟达知识。
But he may not be a Vaishnava, he may not be a devotee.
但是他有可能并不是一位 Vaishnava 奉献者。
So he cannot be a guru.
所以他不能成为一位灵性导师 guru.
Right. He may be a brahmana, but doesn't mean he's a Vaishnava.
他可能是一个婆罗门，但这并不意味着他是一位奉献者。
And if he's not a devotee, then he cannot be a guru.
如果他不是一个奉献者，他无法成为一个 guru 灵性导师。
So an expert brahmana may not be a Vaishnava.
一位精干的婆罗门可能不是 Vaishnava 奉献者。
But if somebody is a Vaishnava, then they're already a brahmana.
但如果一个人是 Vaishnava 奉献者，他已经就是一位婆罗门了。
To give an example, a millionaire may very easily have hundreds and thousands of dollars.
再举一个类似的例子，一个百万富翁，他可能轻而易举的就拥有成千上万的美金。
But somebody with hundreds and thousands of dollars may not be a millionaire.
而一个拥有成千上万美金的人，他却不一定是一位百万富翁。
But Vridhasura, he was a perfect Vaishnava, so he was also a Brahmana.
Vritrasura 是一位完美的奉献者 Vaishnava 奉献者，因此他也是一位婆罗门。
So Sukadeva Goswami says, when all the great sages and demigods saw the power of Vritrasura, they were very impressed. They understood, oh, he's very powerful.
当 Sukadeva Goswami 继续说道，当所有的伟大圣人和半神都被 Vritrasura 的力量所打扰的时候，
they had actually came, all the different demigods and great sages, they had come to ask Indra to kill the demon Vritrasura.
他们被这个威车苏热的力量震惊的震惊又被打扰的时候，他们就聚集到一起，想请求 Indra 杀死威车苏热。
But Indra, he was afraid of killing a brahmana. He didn't like to do that.
但是 Indra 他非常害怕去杀死一位婆罗门，于是他拒绝了这一请求。
Indra knew that to kill a brahmana is not good.
Indra 他知道，如果杀害一个婆罗门是不好的。
So Indra replied to the demigods that, he said, when I killed Vishwarup, I received sinful reactions.
Indra 这个时候就开始说了，当我杀死 Vishwarup 的时候，我接受了巨大的罪恶反应。
Right, Vishwarup had also he'd been hired by Indra to be the guru of the demigods.
我们还记得 Vishwarup 是被 Indra 所雇佣的，成为他们半神的灵性导师的。
But when Vishwarup was serving the demigods, he was also offering certain oblations on behalf of the demons. So Indra found out.That he was not just serving the demigods, but he was also serving the demons. So Indra killed him.
我们还记得先前 Vishwarup 他在服务半神的同时，他也把祭品给了这些恶魔。当 Indra 发现了 Vishwarup 这么干的时候，于是他就杀掉了 Vishwarup.
So when Indra killed Vishwarup, that was when the father of Vishwarup did a yagya to get a son.Who would be Indra's enemy?
当 Vishwarup 被杀掉了之后 ，Vishwarup 的父亲于是就从火祭就做了一个火祭，想从火祭中求得一个能够成杀死 Indra 的人。
And so that was Vritasura who was born from the fire. He was meant to be Indra's enemy.
这个时候就从祭火之中产生了Vritasura, 他成了 Indra 的敌人。
So Indra is telling about, he said, when I killed Vishwarup, at that time I also got sinful reactions, because Vishwarup was a brahmana, but I killed him.
Indra 就说，当我杀掉 Vishwarup 的时候，我也又接受了很多的罪恶反应，因为他是一位 brahmana, 婆罗门。
So as Indra said, at that time, I gave the sinful reactions away to other people. I was able to give the sinful reactions to different people. I gave some portion to women, I gave some to the land, I gave to the trees, and I gave to water.
Vishwarup, Indra 就说，当我那个时候得到了罪恶反应之后，我就把我所得到的罪恶反应分给了女人、土地、树木和水。
But Indra said, now if I kill Vritasura, is another brahmana, how will I get free from all the sinful reactions?
Indra 这个时候就再继续说了，如果我现在把Vritasura 给杀死，又是一位婆罗门的话，那我现在要承担的这些罪恶反应，我应该如何？免于这种罪恶反应呢？
So in reply to this question from Indra, the great sages told Indra that, oh, don't worry about that. We will perform an Ashwamedha. We'll do Ashwamedha Yagya to release you from any sin.
聆听了 Indra 所说的这一番话之后，在场的这些伟大的圣人就回答 Indra 说，哦，英卓，不要担心，我们会为你举行一场阿什瓦梅达的马祭，这样你就可以免罪了。
All right, you're worried about the sinful reactions of killing a brahmana, but if we do an Ashwamedha Yagya, it will help. It will free you from the sin.
你在害怕杀死一位婆罗门所产生的罪恶反应。但是如果我们为你做这个 Ashwamedha Yagya 的话，你就可以免除这种杀害婆罗门的罪恶。
And the rishis, they told Indra, they said, by doing Ashwamedha Yagya, you'll please the Supreme Lord.
这些圣人继续说，当我们能给你做这个阿什瓦梅的亚吉马祭的时候，你就能够取悦至尊主。
And the Supreme Lord Narayan is the super soul in the heart of everyone. He is the supreme controller.
至尊主 Narayana 他不仅是至尊主，他还是一位超灵。
And the rishis told Indra, they said, you can get free of the sinful reactions even if you kill the whole world. But you just killed one demon, Vritasura. But if you do this yagya and you please Lord Narayan, you could get free from killing the whole world.
这些圣人们说，一个人可以免除甚至杀害整个世界的罪恶反应，更何况你仅仅只是杀死了一个像 Vritasura 这样的恶魔呢？
Somebody may have killed a brahmana.
有人或许杀害了一个婆罗门。
Or somebody kills a cow.
或者有人杀害了一头乳牛。
Or maybe he kills his father or his mother or spiritual master.
有人或者杀害了自己的父亲、母亲或者灵性导师。
But he can get freed from all the sinful reactions simply by chanting the holy name of Lord Narayan.
这样的人仅仅依靠唱诵主 Narayana 的圣名，便能立即免除所有的罪恶反应。
And sinful people like people who eat dogs,and chandalas, and who are lower than sudra, they can also get freed of sinful reactions in this way.
其他的人，比如像那些吃狗者，像那些 chandala, 还有那些甚至不如 sudra 的人，那些低等阶层的人，他们都可以通过这种唱诵主哪那样的圣名的方式，免除这样的罪恶。
But they say to Indra, you are a devotee, and we shall help you by performing the great horse sacrifice.
圣人们继续说，因为你是一个奉献者，所以我们将为你举行一场伟大的马祭。
And if you please Lord Narayan in that way, you don't have to be afraid.
我们以这样的方式帮助你，假如你以这样的方式取悦了主拿人样的，那你还有什么好害怕的呢？
Even if you kill the entire universe and all the brahmanas,
即便你是杀害了整个宇宙，甚至包括婆罗门的罪恶，
But all you did, you're just going to kill one demon who was giving a lot of trouble, who was creating a lot of disturbance.
但是你仅仅做的只是杀害了一个像 Vritasura 这样的搅乱的恶魔而已。
So like this, the rishis are trying to pacify Indra. They don't want him to get too worried.
就这样，这些圣人们就这样安慰着 Indra， 希望他不要太过于担心。
So in the purport.Srila Prabhupada quotes a nice statement from Jagadananda Pandit in his book. Jagadananda Pandit wrote a book called Prema Vivarta.
在要旨中，圣帕帕的引用了一段来自经典的话。这个是 Jagadananda Pandit 写的 Prema Vivarta 中的一段话。
So Jagadananda had written, Eka Krishna Name Papira.Yata papashaya, bahu janme se papi karite naraya. This means that by once chanting the holy name of the Lord, one can be freed from the reactions of more sins than he can even imagine performing.
这意味着靠唱诵主圣名，主那样的圣名一次。人便能免除比甚至所想象的所犯下的罪行更多的罪恶反应。
The holy name is so powerful that simply by chanting the holy name, we can get freed from the reactions of all sinful activities.
圣名是如此具有灵性的力量，仅仅靠唱诵主的圣名，便能免除所有的罪恶反应。
And if you chant the holy name regularly, it will be even more powerful.
那么，更何况那些有规律的唱诵主的圣名呢？这无疑是具有更大的力量的。
Or maybe you also worship the deity regularly. That can also help to make you very powerful.
而且还有那些有规律的崇拜神像的人呢，这也会帮助你更有力量。
Certainly, by doing these two things, chanting the holy name and worshiping the deity, you can get freed from sinful reactions.
那些有规律的唱诵圣名的人，以及那些有规律的崇拜神像的人，他们都能够帮助，就是说，这都能帮助你免除罪恶的反应。
However, we should understand that we should not ever commit sinful acts intentionally.
这里所引用的这个世界也让我们从另外角度去理解，我们不应该有意的去做出冒犯。
Don't think just because you're chanting the holy name that you will get free from all the sinful reactions.
我们不要想着我们可以通过唱诵圣名就能免除掉我们所有的罪恶反应。
That is a great offense at the feet of the holy name.
这是对圣名莲花足下的一种冒犯。
It said, "Namno baladya shyahi papa buti," to commit sinful activities on the strength of chanting the holy name is very sinful.
我们唱诵圣名十诫之中有这样，借着唱诵主的圣名行恶，这是在所有的冒犯之中非常严重的、严肃的一条。
So Krishna's holy name certainly can destroy all sinful reactions.
主 Krishna 的圣名毫无疑问的能够摧毁我们所有的罪恶反应。
But if we again and again and intentionally commit sins while chanting the holy name, then it is very, very bad.
但是如果一个人一而再、再而三的故意去犯罪，而同时唱诵圣名的话，这样是一个非常大的冒犯。
And you get a lot of punishment for that.
你会得到巨大的惩罚的。
So there's in the scriptures we learn different things about different sinful activities.
在不同的经典，我们了解到了不同的罪恶活动。
Somebody, a son may be born from a brahmana and from the womb of a sudra woman.
一位可能是婆罗门的儿子，但是呢，他是由苏哲的子宫之中诞生的。
So that kind of son, he is a nishada or parasava.
这样的儿子被称为 Parasava 或 Nishada.
Means a hunter who has a habit to steal.
这意味着他是有去偷盗的习惯。
And if a son, if there's a son be conceived in the womb of a Sudra woman, if there's a son conceived by a Nishada in the womb of a Sudra woman,Then that son is called Pukasha.
这样的一位儿子，就是说有这样的一个 Nishada 的儿子，如果他又在一个输着的妇女之中得到一个生下一个孩子的话，这个孩子又被称为 Pukasha.
And a child who may be conceived by a Kshatriya.In the womb of a daughter of a sudra, then that child is called an ugra.
一位 Kshatriya 在一位 Shudra 的女人的子宫之中生的孩子叫 ugra.
Yeah. And a child who's conceived in the womb of a Sudra woman, the daughter of a Kshatriya, then that child is called Shata.
一位淑者在一位 Kshatriya 的女儿的子宫之中所生的孩子叫做 Kashta.
And a child who's begotten by a Kshatriya in the womb of a lower class woman is called Swada.
一位 Kshatriya 在一位低等的妇女的子宫之中所生的孩子叫做 Swada.
Swada means dog eater.
Swada 的意思是吃狗者，吃狗肉，吃狗者。
So all these kind of offspring are considered very sinful.
所有这些被描所有这些后代都被描述被认为是罪恶的。
But the holy name of the personality of Godhead is so powerful that all of these sinful people can all be purified simply by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra.
但是至尊人格首身的圣名是非常的如此的强大，仅仅靠唱诵至尊主的圣名，这个伟大的曼陀罗，他们都能够得到净化。
The Hare Krishna movement gives everyone a chance to get purified.
Hare Krishna 运动是给予每一个家庭每一个人以机会给予他们机会获得净化。
Doesn't matter about what kind of birth, what kind of family you're born in. Are they low class or high class? Are they Brahmin or Shudra?
这个 Hare Krishna 运动它不管你是出生于什么样的背景家庭或是来自于什么样的阶层。无论是谁，他都能够给你净化。
Everyone gets a chance to become a devotee.
每一个人都能够得到机会成为奉献者。
So there's this nice verse which comes in the second canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
在《圣典波迦瓦坛》第二篇里面有这样一个诗节。
It's spoken by Shaunaka Rishi.
是 Shaunaka 圣人所说的。
Speaking about the power of Krishna's devotees.
这里描述到的 Krishna 的奉献者的力量。
Kirita Hunandra Palinda Bokasha Abira Shumba Yavana Koshadaya Yanye Tapapa Yadapashraya Shraya Shujanti Tasmai Prabhavishnave Nama. So this verse is.Describing different kinds of sinful people.
这一节诗里面讲述了不同种类的他们非常罪恶的人。
Kirita is a kind of tribal people who are, it may be sometimes African people are considered Kirata, but they may also be Bihari people.
Kirita, 有的时候我们说有可能是来自于非洲的人，有可能是 Bihari。
Bihar, the state of India.
哦 ，Bihar, Bihar 也是，就是印度的某一个州或者省。
And then you have Huns, Huns, the Huns. This is German people, the Huns.
这里面提到的 Hunas, 这个 Hunas 指的是德国人。
And Andhra.Is a state in South India.
Andhra, 这个指是南印度部分的。
And Palinda, these are tribal people, Aborigine people.
Palinda 是Aborigine
people. Aborigine means tribal people.
Sorry, tribal, I don't.
They're natives of the jungle. They just live in the jungle.
Okay, 就是那些住在丛林之中的人。
And then you've got people like the Greeks, and you've got the Turks also, like the Yavanas, that's the Turks.
还有 Yavanas.
Turkey.
土耳其 Yavanas. 这里提到的 Yamanas 是指土耳其那边的。
And Abira, these are other people who were driven out of India. When Lord Parasuram was killing the Kshatriyas 21 times, then many Kshatriyas, they all left India and they went to Europe.
当 Parasurama 杀害了，就是杀，把这个 Kshatriya 杀了21次之后，21个轮回之后，21次之后，很多的 Kshatriya，还有很多的插曲，他们当时就去到了欧洲这一带。
But Sukadeva Goswami said all of these. Oh no, Shonaka Rishi said all of these people can be delivered. Oh no, this is Sukadeva Goswami speaking, right? This is Sukadeva Goswami offering prayers, because Sukadeva Goswami had been asked to speak about creation. So before he spoke about creation, he first of all offered prayers.
这里是 Sukadeva Goswami 所描述的，因为在 Sukadeva Goswami 向描述这个创造之前，他向至尊主供奉的这个祈祷文，这个也是来自于祈祷文中的一部分。他描述了所有的这些种类的人，他们都可以通过唱诵主的圣名而得到净化。
So even these people, all these different races, they're sinful people, means they have bad karma.
所有的这些人，他们都算是罪恶的人，意味着他们都有很多不好的业报。
Right, and we see the, Kashadaya. Kasha is there. That's the China people, or that's the Tibetan people there. Kasha, and Adaya is others.
这里面提到的 Kasha 是指的中国。
So.You know, we're, the whole world is full of sinful people.
整个世界其实都是充满着罪恶的。
But they can all be delivered. They can all be purified by taking shelter of a devotee of the Supreme Lord.
这里面提到的要点就是，所有的整个世界的人都可以能够通过圣名，通过得到奉献者的庇护，都能够得到净化。
Right.We have to take shelter of a pure devotee.
我们应该托庇于纯粹奉献者。
And the devotee can help to protect us from all the bad karma.
奉献者能够保护我们免于这些非常不好的业报、恶报。
And these sinful people, the sinful people can all be purified by chanting the holy name.
而且这些不管是哪些罪恶的人，他们都可以通过唱诵圣名得到净化。
But they have to take the instruction. They have to take the help of a pure devotee.
但是他们得接受纯粹奉献者的帮助，得接受纯粹奉献者的指导。
We want to get purified. You have to get the mercy of a devotee.
我们想要得到净化，我们就得得到纯粹奉献者的仁慈。
And that will.Help us to get rid of all of our karma.
这样我们才能够免除所有的不好的业报。
So the sages, they want to encourage Indra, because they want Indra to kill this demon. This is before Indra had killed the demon. So the sages had spoke like this to Indra that he should kill the demon.
这个是在战争之前，这些圣人们都在鼓励着 Indra。他希望英准能够杀掉这个恶魔。
And the sages, they knew that this demon is a brahmana.
他们知道他们要杀的这个人是一个婆罗门。
But they told Indra, you don't worry about it.
他们告诉英准，你不要担心这个。
So you kill Vritasura, he's a brahmana, so you're guilty of killing a brahmana.Doesn't matter.
你杀掉这个恶魔，他虽然是一个婆罗门，但是你杀掉这个婆罗门，你也不要担心。
We'll do the Ashwamedha Yagya, and you'll get free of all the sinful reactions.
我们会做这个 Ashwamedha 的祭祀，让你免除罪恶的业报。
Of course, that kind of talk, this is not good to do like that.
当然从这样的谈话之中去就是说其实这去这样说或者说这样做并不好。
Right, this is an offense, just like chanting the holy name. If you do sinful activities and you chant the holy name to make up for your sinful activities, that's a great offense.
就像我们说的唱诵圣名十诫中的描述的那个情况，你去做一个罪恶活动，然后你又想着通过念诵去唱诵圣名来中和掉你这种罪恶活动，这实际上是一种冒犯，这并不好。
So yeah, we have to get rid of the sinful acts. Not just simply, if we do something sinful on purpose, and then think that we can get freed from the reactions by doing some atonement, that's not good.
如果我们想去从事某些罪恶活动，而且还是有意而为之，之后呢，又想通过做一些忏悔去中和掉这样的罪恶反应，这是一个冒犯，并不好。
So these rishis, they shouldn't have told Indra like that.
这些圣人不应该这么跟 Indra 去讲。
Yeah, it was certainly not proper instruction to give Indra.
不，这个其实不应该算是一个很恰当的训示给予 Indra。
Okay, are there any questions?
Okay.Question, not yet. Daja, can you put the question in the chat? Now, I haven't seen the question. Hare Krishna Gurudev.
Will we go ahead?
You depend on you. We wait 1 minute or?
No, we'll just do one more verse.
Okay, okay.、
Okay, so Sukadeva Goswami said, when Indra heard these words of the great sages, then he became encouraged and he thought, oh, okay, then I'll kill Vritasura.
Sukadeva Goswami 就说当 Indra 听到了圣人们所说的这番话之后他备受鼓舞于是他就决定要杀死 Vritasura.
So Indra killed Vritasura, and then after he killed him, then the sinful reactions came.
当 Vritasura 被杀死了之后 ，Indra 就杀害了一个婆罗门，于是业报肯定就来了。
Because he killed a brahmana, so he had to suffer the reactions for killing a brahmana. It's a big, big sin, very sinful.
因为他杀害了一个婆罗门，杀害了一个婆罗门是一个很大的罪恶，这个罪恶肯定是要来的。
So the sinful reactions came on Indra.
罪恶反应就于是来到了 Indra 这儿。
Yes, after he killed Vritasura, Indra couldn't he couldn't avoid the sinful reactions.
当 Indra 杀掉了Vritasura 之后他无法避免这个罪恶反应。
In the past, he had killed that other brahmana, Vishwarup.
在先前他杀害了另外一个婆罗门 Vishwarup.
And at that time, he got rid of some of the reactions by giving them to other people.
在那一次他把自己所得到的罪恶反应分摊给了其他的人。
Actually, when he killed that first brahmana, when he killed Vishwarup, he did it impulsively. He did it. He got angry and he just killed him, cut off his head. He without thinking. He did it impulsively.
在那一次他杀掉那个婆罗门的时候，
他突然的。把 Vishwarupa
哦，他是突然的就把 Vishwarupa 给杀害了。
He didn't think about it.
他当时想都没有多想。
He just, you know, he saw that Vishwarupa was cheating, doing the yagya, and he was so angry he killed him.
他在那个时候看到了维什瓦卢帕在做这个压扁，他把这个东西给有点欺骗性质，他发现了他的欺骗行为，然后立马就把他给杀了。
But with Vishwarupa, or with, rather with Vritasura, the second one, with Vritasura, this time he killed him, he killed the Brahmana on purpose.
而这一次他杀掉了 Vritasura, 他这次的行为更严重，是因为他是有意而为之的。
Because he was hearing the advice of the sages, so he thought, yeah, it's okay, I can do it, and they will help me to get rid of the sinful reactions. But the sinful reactions, when he did it on purpose, was much greater than when he did itimpulsively, when he did it without thinking.
这种罪恶反应就是你无意之间所犯下的罪恶反应，就是你有意而为之所犯下的罪恶反应远远要大于你无意而为之的这种罪恶反应。
So because there was greater sinful reactions, Indra, he couldn't get free of the reactions. He wasn't able to give them to anybody else.
因为这个罪恶反应非常的大，而且 他无法把这个罪恶反应分摊给别人。
And it wasn't enough to just do a yajna to get rid of it. That wasn't enough for the atonement. He was thinking, I just do a yajna and I'll get rid of all the sins, but that was not enough.
他在想通过这个马迹就可以结束了，但是这远远都是不够的。
He had to undergo a lot of different reactions. He got a lot of reactions from his sinful reactions.
So he had to undergo a lot of different reactions.
And he had to suffer. And the reactions brought him a lot of suffering.
And his sinful reactions brought him a lot of suffering.
So after a long time, he got freed from the sinful, from the suffering, and then the brahmanas allowed him to do the yajna, to do the horse sacrifice, the ashwamedha.
当他免除了所有这些痛苦了之后，婆罗门这些 brahmana 允许他再去做这个马迹。
So because he was planning, making a plan, deliberately he was planning to do these sinful things. And he was planning to counteract it through the chanting of the holy name of the Lord. The other kind of atonement, like prayaschit, he was planning to do the yajna.
He also wanted to do the other kind of atonement, like prayaschit, he was planning to do the yajna. He also wanted to do the other kind
of atonement, like prayaschit, he was planning to do the yajna.
But that's not enough to get free from the sinful reactions.
Even if you're Indra, the king of heaven, or Nahusha,a great demigod, you get the sinful reactions.
即便是像天堂的国王 Indra 或者说 Nahusha 这样的伟大的半神，他们都无法 得到救赎，他们无法免除这种罪恶反应。
Nahusha actually, he took the place of Indra because Indra had to go, he had to go different places to try to get free from the sinful reactions.So when Indra was going around trying to get free of his sins, somebody has to take Indra's place. So that was done by Nahusha.
当 Indra 不在天堂，他去为了他的罪恶反应到处去寻求庇护、寻求救赎的这一段时间， Nahusha 代替 Indra 执政。
Okay.
Okay.
We will stop now.
Here. Okay. Here I have many questions.First question, from 真真 Hare Krishna, 敬爱的 Guru Maharaj, 顶拜年年天美莲花族。 顶拜所有的奉献者想问咕噜，恐惧藏在什么地方？为什么会有恐惧？怎样就能无所畏惧？ Hare Krishna obeisance to dear Guru Maharaj, obeisance to your lotus feet and all devotees. I want to ask Guru Dev, where is the fearness hide?
Huh? Where is the what?
Fear. F-E-A-R.
Where is fear?
Yeah.
Fear is in the mind.
恐惧在心意里面。
Yeah, we're afraid. We're afraid sometimes
yeah.
of dishonor, sometimes or disgrace, or sometimes we're afraid somebody may be nasty to us, say something nasty to us.
我们非常的担心，担心某人会对我们，有一些攻击，或者说说一些不好的话，对于我们。
Fear. We have fear of not being as good as other people. Sometimes if we think, oh, I'm not as successful as others, then that we have a fear about that.
我们有时候担心自己对他人不好，或者说相比于其他人而言，我们没有那么的成功，我们也会恐惧这些。
Everybody else is learning very nicely and I'm not learning.
每一个人都学习的非常非常的博学，非常的有知识有文化，但是我不是那么的有学识。
So we get fear sometimes about these things.
所以我们就会对这些事情感觉到恐惧。 And why we have this kind of fear?
Because we think we're the body.
我们为什么会恐惧呢？是因为我们在思考着，我们认为我们是这个躯体。
Right? We're identifying with the body. We're not identifying with the soul.
我们在与我们的躯体相认同，我们并不与我们的灵魂相认同。
So because we're in the bodily consciousness, we have that kind of feeling.
因为我们有躯体化的概念，所以我们会有这些各种各样的恐惧。And how can we, how come we are not be free? We are not be free.
Well, you have to get out of the bodily consciousness. You have to become Krishna conscious.
你想，不再恐惧，那你就得免除你这种躯体化的概念，回到 Krishna 知觉之中来。
When you chant Hare Krishna mantra, then your consciousness will come up to the transcendental platform.
当你唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗的时候，你的知觉应该来到超然的层面上。
We want to bring our consciousness out of that bodily condition.And bring it up to the spiritual platform.
我们应该把我们的知觉带离、脱离掉这种躯体化的概念，来到超然的层面上。
On the spiritual platform, there's no fear.
在超然的层面上，我们是无所畏惧的。
Because the spirit souls, the spiritual beings, we have nothing to fear.
因为我们是离心的灵魂，我们没有什么应该去害怕的。
Recording stopped.
So try to understand the benefit of being in spiritual consciousness.
所以要去理解，成为你要你能够去理解到你自己是离心的灵魂的这种益处好处。
So Krishna consciousness is an awakening. You know, at night when we dream, we may dream, oh, a tiger is coming to eat me. And we're afraid and we're running. Oh, tiger, no, tiger's coming. And we're running, running, tiger's chasing us.
其实我们所在的这个生活就像一场梦一样。比如说我们在梦里会梦见一只老虎。
Recording in progress.
哦，有一只老虎在追着我，有一只老虎要吃了我。
And then you wake up from the dream.
然后你就从梦中醒来了。之后没有什么好害怕的，就梦里的一切没有什么，你就没有什么好害怕的。现在可以理解一点吗？真正妈的经 Hare Krishna。
Yes.
Okay. Next question from Yuna Madaji. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj and the dear devotees, please accept my humble base on Golodik Srila Papa. Is pain a manifestation of faulty mentality? Let me check.
Is pain a manifestation of bodily mentality?
Yeah.这个他这个 Yuna Madaji 所问的问题是，疼痛是不是错误心态的表现，错误的思考的一种展示。嗯， Hare Krishna。
Yes，
是的。
Yes, pain is a manifestation of bodily consciousness。
疼痛是一种躯体化概念的感受。
Sometimes people are able to tolerate a great amount of pain without any disturbance.
有些时候人是可以在巨大的疼痛面前仍然不受打扰的。
Just like we heard about Stalin, right? Stalin, Yuna is from Russia, so Stalin was a great leader in Russia. So at one point Stalin had to have a surgery, had to have an operation.But he wouldn't take any anesthetic. He refused to be put unconscious. And he kept a gun in his hand in case anything happened. So he was able to tolerate the pain of the surgery. And he didn't take any anesthetic.
故事描述的是这样一个情况，好像就是Yuna Mother 其实来自俄罗斯的，描述了俄罗斯的这个斯大林。他是一个非常勇敢的人，他在有一个要对他手臂还是要做手术的时候，他没有去打任何的麻药，他就拿着一把枪在那里，他好像是不受能够承受得了这种痛苦。
嗯， Yes, sometimes, yeah, Some people get a little pain and they're greatly disturbed, and other people get a lot of pain and they don't bother about it, they just tolerate it.
有一类人他是有一丁点的痛苦他都疼得要死，但是还有一类人他是得到了很大的痛苦，但是他好像一点反应都没有，他完全能够容忍这样的情况。
Well, we saw Srila Prabhupada,
Recording stopped.
Srila Prabhupada's body had become very emaciated, become very thin, and all the nerves were resting on the bones.
Srila Prabhupada 在晚年的时候变得非常的瘦，而且他所有的这个就是恨不得就成皮包骨头的那种状态。
But he allowed people to come and give him massage, so it must have been a lot of pain for him, but Prabhupada tolerated it.
他邀请人们，希望人们给他做一些 massage， 给他做一些按摩，但是实际上这可能他在这个过程中也会承受很大的痛苦。
So people who are in transcendental consciousness, they don't feel pain of the body.
有一些处在超然层面上的人，他并不对这个躯体太感受或者说在意，他并不受打扰。
嗯。OK。
OK。Next question from Jai Govinda David Dasi。顶拜亲爱的 Guru 和翻译，通常门徒在得到 Guru 的启迪的时候会做一个火祭，请问这个火祭带来的好处是什么？是摧毁过去的罪恶反应吗？谢谢 Guru。 A basis to Guru and translate. Usually, when the when the disciple get the initiation, and usually they will have the ceremony of the fire sacrifice. So what's the benefit of this fire sacrifice? Is that means it can destroy all the sinful, the past sins, sinful reaction?
No. The fire sacrifice, well, the fire is the representative of Lord Vishnu. It's like the mouth of Vishnu.
这个火代表的是主威士奴的嘴。
So, we do the fire sacrifice. Actually, what's supposed to happen, you make your vow in front of the fire, and the fire is like a witness.
我们在火的面前做这个祭祀，是让主威士奴能够见证你的誓言。
Just like at the time of initiation, you make a vow, you promise to follow and to chant rounds. And so the fire is the mouth of Lord Vishnu. So we make the vow in front of the fire. So it's a witness to our vow.
就像在起乩的时候，你会发下誓言，说要念诵，要遵守四项基本原则。而这个火代表的是主威士奴，他在见证着你发下的这个誓言。
Recording in progress.
Why it happened, Hare Krishna.
So, the sacrificial fire is actually the ritual.
这个火祭实际上是一种仪式。
The important thing is the chanting of the holy name.
这个最重要的事情是唱诵主的圣名。
You can destroy all sinful reactions by chanting the holy name.
我们可以通过唱诵主的圣名来摧毁掉所有的罪恶反应。
Some people do say that the fire is burning up the sinful reactions, but actually, when you come for initiation, you're supposed to be free from your sinful reactions.
有一些人认为是这个火祭能够摧毁你的罪恶反应。实际上，在你来参加火祭之前，你应该是免于罪恶的反应的。
Yes, by chanting Hare Krishna regularly, and by following the four principles, and by reading the shastra and hearing the philosophy, we get free of all the sinful reactions.
在你阅读经典的时候，在你念诵的时候，在你遵守这些所有的规范誓言的时候，这些都能够让你免除这些罪恶反应。
The fire that's doing the yagya is more a show than it's not so meaningful. It's just to, it's something which makes an impression on people. People like to see it.
这个火祭有时候更多的是像一个展示，让你有一个深刻的印象，而意义不是说它有多大多大的意义，它只是让你有一个深刻的印象。
We know that in the Kali Yuga, the process is the chanting of the holy name. The process is not doing a yagya.
我们知道卡利年代的程序是唱诵主的圣名，这个卡利年代的程序不是说做这个火祭。Next question.
Okay.
Next question from Nila Avatar Manaji, 顶拜孤儿和所有的奉献者。博迦梵歌第六章诗节三诗文中说，对已经在瑜伽中取得更高晋升的人，停止一切物质活动乃是手段。对于这个停止一切活动乃是手段，我觉得好难理解啊！能帮我详细的讲解一下这一句话的深意吗？感恩。Obeisances to Guru and all devotees. In the Bhagavad Gita, 6th chapter, verse 3, it says that, to the. Chapter 6, number 3.
Okay. For one who is a neophyte in the Eightfold Yoga system, work is said to be the means. And for one who is already elevated in yoga, cessation of all material activities is said to be the means.
So she wants to know how to understand the second part. Stop all the activity, cessations of all the material activity is said to be the means. How to understand this?
Yes, cessation of all material activities. Okay, so you stop all the maya. You don't any nonsense activities, right?
这个停止一切物质活动意味着就是你停止和玛雅的联谊，停止和虚幻能量联谊，停止所有这些胡作非为的事情。
Right, in the beginning it said in the lower stages of yoga, the neophyte, Eightfold Yoga system, work is said to be the means. So what is that work? That work is which will purify us, that is doing, you know, like karma yoga, maybe you do charity, you do austerities, you chant mantras, you could simply do bhakti yoga. And this way, by bhakti yoga, then it's a means to come to a higher level.
在初级阶段，一个人可能会去做苦行，会去做 karma yoga， 会去做其他的各种各样的方式。但是当一个人提升到 bhakti yoga 的时候，这个实际上他就已经到一种瑜伽的更高级的阶段了。
Okay, I'll read Prabhupada's purport. Prabhupada says, a Krishna conscious person, however, is situated from the beginning on the platform of meditation because he always thinks of Krishna. And being constantly engaged in the service of Krishna, he is considered to have ceased all material activities. So he doesn't, you know, one who is a devotee, he doesn't do any material activities. That's what we said, that the higher stage of the advanced yogi, he ceases all work, all material activities. He doesn't stop all work, he stops all material activities. So he doesn't bother with material activities, like he's not interested in cultivating knowledge, and he's not interested in doing austerities, and he's not interested in doing yoga, and he's not interested in... what will he do? And he's advanced in yoga, he will just simply engage in bhakti yoga. He would simply engage in hearing and chanting and remembering Krishna.
不如刚刚读了一下这个要旨，然后就是说，关于初级阶段，他可能会做各种各样的活动，但是他当他晋升到比较高级的阶段，比如说风爱瑜伽的阶段的时候，你看不到这个做风爱瑜伽的人他在从事各种各样的苦行也好，思辨也好，他所做的一切都是你看不到这样的风爱瑜伽的人他在从事任何的物质活动，他也不被任何的物质活动所打扰，他做的一切都是风爱瑜伽的活动，他对其他的苦行、karma yoga 还有思辨等等这些活动，他对他们没有什么兴趣。他从事的都是 bhakti 奉爱瑜伽的活动，这意味着他只是专注于聆听和唱诵，然后想着 Krishna， 聆听唱诵想着 Krishna。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, in the third canto, the first chapter of the third canto describes about Vidura and how Vidura had been staying in the palace with Duryodhana and Dhritarashtra, and then Duryodhana kicked him out of the palace.
在圣典薄伽瓦坛第三篇的第一章大概就描述了杜优达哦不维杜拉的他的一生的这个情况，就在他生命的比较稍后半部分的时候，他之前是住在宫殿里的，然后他被踢除到宫殿外面去了。
So he could have immediately went to Krishna and taken shelter of Lord Krishna.
He could not or could.
He could have.
他可以是直接去找 Krishna, 然后托庇 Krishna.
But he didn't do that.
但是他没有那么去做。
Because he wasn't freed of sinful reactions.
因为他还没有免除罪恶反应。
So he had to get free of all his sinful reactions first before he could properly take up devotional service.
所以在他在他免除罪恶反应之前，他还得做一些其他的活动，能让他在他要进入到 Bhakti Yoga 之前，他还得免除一些罪恶的反应。
So how did he get free of all of his sinful reactions?
他是如何免除掉所有的罪恶反应的
？He went to visit holy places for many years.
他去这些绕拜圣地花了很多年。
And he bathed in all the holy rivers.
他在所有的这些圣河之中沐浴。
And he observed the Ekadasi.
他遵守阿克达西。
And he did all of these different things, different duties.
他做了。各种各样不同的职责，从事了各种各样不同的活动。
And after he'd done that for many years, then he was ready to come and do full devotional service and just hear about serve Krishna.
在他做了很多年之后，他才决定准备好了，他才完全的托庇在 Krishna 的莲花足下。
So this is the idea, right? You know that.The neophyte, they have to do all these kind of things. But one who is advanced in yoga, he doesn't have to do all these things.
对于一个初级者，他想要必须得做这些东西。但是对一个很高级的、这很精进的人来说，他没必要这么去做。
He will just chant Hare Krishna. He will just read the Bhagavatam.
他只需要唱诵 Hare Krishna, 他只需要阅读圣典薄伽瓦坛。
He's satisfied to do these things.
他是非常满足于做这些活动的。
But other people, they have to get rid of all the sinful reactions first.
但是其他的人他们都得免除掉这些罪恶反应。
And they will do it by doing different kinds of pious activities.
而且他们会通过各种各样的虔诚活动去确实这么去做。
Like I said, going to visit the holy places and bathing in the holy rivers and going to see the temples and deities.
去各种各样的圣地去绕拜，去圣河沐浴，然后去觐见神像。
And then gradually come.They come to the higher level of yoga.
然后逐渐地提升到瑜伽的高级阶段。
And they can just sit and chant Hare Krishna.
然后再来坐下来好好的唱诵。
All right? Is that all right? Little Avatar Mataji?
Little Avatar Mataji, 现在可以理解吗？
Okay, go ahead.
Oh, okay, okay. Next question from Taiwan Sumuki Gopika Dasi. 顶拜 Maharaj 翻译和所有的奉献者，请问为何能把自己的罪恶反应分给别人？被分到的生物是不是很无辜？那另外一个问题，在恶魔进入到三摩地时砍下他的头，听起来趁人不备，很不光荣，能这样做吗？She have two questions. First part, obeisance Maharaj and all devotees. Why the Indra can share his sinful reaction to the others? Because the other people are 无辜.
Okay.
Sorry, wait 1 minute. Ugu means innocent.
Innocent, okay.
Innocent. This is the first question.
Why Indra can show his sinful reaction? Well, remember we explained that these people had already taken blessings from Indra before, that he'd given them benedictions for their sense gratification.
我们在先前讲过这个，就是这些被就是Indra分给罪恶反应的这三个大地啊、女人呐、啊，还有这个河流，还是他们之前享受过Indra的好处，他们得以很感官享乐，得到他的好处，于是这样的一个情况，他们之前得到过Indra的好处利益。
Yeah, he gave benedictions, you know, like women can enjoy lusty desires even when they're pregnant.
就像先前圣殿伯伽梵谈讲的，女性甚至可以在她怀孕的时候也仍然进行性的感官享乐，这也是Indra给予她的好处。 The second question is, sorry, Gurudev.
And when the tree's branches are cut off, they grow back, they grow again.
当树的枝干被砍掉的时候，它仍然还可以上长。
Yeah, and water got the benediction; it could mix with anything.
当水得到祝福时，它可以做成任何别的形状，还是。
Right. So they all had taken some benediction. Indra had given them something initially. And so when he got sinful reactions, he said, I helped you, now you have to help me.
因为Indra给了这三类他们的好处, 所以我之前帮过你，你现在就得帮助我了。
So he gave them half, he gave them his sinful reactions. He divided up between four things.
所以Indra就把这个 他的罪恶反应分成了四份，把这三个就给了他们。
The women, the trees, the land, and the water.
把罪恶反应分给了树木、河流、大地和女人。
Okay.
Second question, she asked, when the demon, this we, I think Vaitrasura, go into the yoga samadhi and the Indra cut off his head. It sounds like unprepared and unhonorable. Is this kind of activities right or properly?
Well, is it proper to cut off someone's head?
Because the Vaitrasura is in the yoga samadhi and the Indra cut off his head, it sounds unprepared.
But Indra didn't know he was in samadhi.
Okay. Indra并不知道他进入到samadhi的这个境界。
Indra had already been swallowed by Vritasura, and then Vritasura sat in samadhi. So Indra wasn't aware that Vritasura had taken samadhi.
因为Indra已经被Vritasura给吞掉了，他并不知道Vritasura在samadhi的状态之中。
And he would be worried that Vritasura might come back to life.
而且他还非常担心Vritasura再一次活过来。
That was why he cut off his head.
所以他就为什么要砍掉他的头。 Next question. Next question from Jai Govinda. 若是有人利用圣名来抵消自己的罪恶反应，虽然是一种冒犯，是不是比那些从来没有念过一句圣名的人要高尚的呢？ If someone even do some offense during the chanting, for example, he do some sinful activities and during the chanting. This kind of activities is offense. But these people are more higher than who never chant the holy name.
Which people are more high who never chant?
The first one is today you said one is chanting the holy name, but he's do some sinful activities properly. Sinful activities
okay.
Intense. Not intense. How to say? 有意的.
Purposely.
These people is higher than who is never chant the holy name.
Well, I don't know who's. I don't know. It's very sinful to do something like that, to chant the holy name and to do sinful activities to counteract the offense, to try to commit sins on the strength of chanting is offensive. But you're right, offensive chanting is better than not chanting.
你说的是对的，就是冒犯的念诵比从不念诵要好。
They need the mercy of a devotee. Some devotee has to come and instruct them that chanting is offensive, that they should not do like that.
奉献者应该站出来去指认，去纠正他，批评他，帮助他，改正他，告诉他这样的冒犯的念诵是很不好的。
So the mercy of a devotee can correct people from offensive chanting.
奉献者的仁慈能够帮助一个奉献者纠正他的冒犯的念诵。
But they're only a little better than somebody else.
但是这仅仅只是好那么一丁点儿。Not
much difference.
实际上没有太大的区别。
Because they want to take advantage of the holy name for their sense gratification.
因为前面你提到的这种人，他是在利用圣名来为他的感官享乐。
Other people, okay, they're just having sense gratification. They're not doing anything. They're not making any offense to the holy name.
其他的人只是在感官享乐，他并没有对圣名做出冒犯。
So it's a question of what's worse, somebody is sinful or someone's offensive.
其实这个要考虑的，这个不是说谁高尚的问题，这个谁到底更坏的问题，你到底要看到底是那些是谁坏，或者说谁更坏。
Somebody is offensive, like Daksha. Daksha, Prajapati Daksha was offensive. And that his head got cut off, and they gave him the head of a goat.
有一些人是冒犯者，比如说祖先 Prajapati Daksha， 他做了一个冒犯，于是他的头被砍下来，被安上了一个羊头。
Now Ajamila, he was attached to sense gratification. He was sinful, but he wasn't offensive.
但是阿加米拉他是一个。 罪恶的人，他虽然罪恶，但他不是一个冒犯者。
The people who are offensive, it's harder for them to get the mercy.
那些冒犯者对于他们来说是要得到仁慈，非常难以得到仁慈的。
But somebody is just sinful. Okay, there's a bit more hope. Just like Ajamila, he was sinful, but he could chant the name at Namabhas.
有一些人虽然罪恶，但是比如说像阿加米勒，他虽然罪恶，但是他能够唱诵到阿南巴巴斯无冒犯唱诵的境界。
And then later on, he went and he got perfection in the same life. He went back to Godhead.
之后他就。 在同一身他能够回归守身。
So I think it may be better somebody sinful rather than offensive.
有时候或许我认为那个这个 sinful 的人就是罪恶的人甚至比那些冒犯者还要好一些。
Yeah. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Next question from Yona. She said, sorry, is the pain a manifestation of a false mentality?
Is pain a manifestation of a false mentality?
Yeah. The same question before?
It's the same question. It's the same. The false mentality is to think I'm the body.
Sorry, Gurudev. I think it's for is the same question.
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Satsanga. Satsanga. Hare Krishna, 顶拜咕噜的莲花族，家里养的图拉西和花生虫可不可以用药灭掉 ？Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. I plant the tushi have some, have some 有虫子 can I use some medicine to cure them?
No. I don't know to kill, you know.We try to practice non-violence. We try not to kill any living entity.
我们尝试着非暴力，我们尽量不要使用暴力对任何的生物体。
So you should try to spray the tosi so that these creatures will get off the tosi.
你可以对它喷一点别的什么东西，然后让这些让它能够远离突袭。
But I don't think you can just kill them.
你如果喷这个药水去杀死他们不好。
You know, when Narada Muni came to see Magrari the hunter, Magrari had been a hunter, but he wouldn't even step on little insects. So they were appreciating Narada Muni and Angira Muni, they were appreciating that this man had been a hunter before.And killing animals, but now he wouldn't even kill little insects.
Narada Muni, 遇见了 Mugari 这一个猎人。当 Narada Muni 改变了 Mugari 的时候，这个猎人甚至到最后就是改变了之后，他连一个小的昆虫他都舍不得去伤害他们。
So we should be conscious about killing other forms of life.
我们应该对其他形体的生命应该有意识的去在意他们保护在意他们不要去随意的杀他们
I don't know where the bugs are coming from who are going to Tosi where are they coming from
我们不知道他们这些虫子是来自于哪里的呢
Is Tosi in your house? I think because you live in the north of China, so Tosi must be in your house, is it?
你是在中国的北方居住着，这个突袭是不是养在你的家里？
So, we have to think how that. Yeah, it depends when you say Yao. When she said Yao, what kind of medicine does she? If it's medicine to kill them, that's not good, you know. But if it's medicine just to get them off and to put them.Get them off Tosi, to keep them off Tosi, that's okay. But you don't want to be killing them.
要去考虑一下你用了什么药。如果这个药只是让这个虫子让这个虫子远离或者说落掉，那是没有问题的。但是如果你要用这个药把这个虫子给灭掉，给杀掉，这个是不行的，这个是不太好的。Next question from Vandavanda.Das, Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev 和所有的奉献者，请问业报 karma 不永恒是指一切冒犯罪恶反应都能去除掉吗？ Hare Krishna, blessings you Guru Dev and all devotees. I want to ask the karma is not internal. It means all the offense and the sinful reactions can all be removed. Is that right?
Yes, that's right.
是的，这是正确的。OK, next question from Kirtananda Devadasi, Dimbai Guru. Mantra 划分为四类，四部伟达，即 Rig Veda, Atar Veda, Yajur Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda, 分别代表什么经典，什么含义呢？ Obeisance to Guru, the mantra divided in four pieces, and four Vedas means Rig Veda,Atra Veda, Yajra Veda, Sam Veda. What are these four Vedas which Shastra represent these four Vedas, and what's the meaning of them?
You have to understand, the Veda was originally one, then it was divided into four.
Veda 经开始只有一部，然后就分成了四部。
So there were four disciples of Vyasadeva, and Vyasadeva gave each of his disciples one of these Vedas.
Vyasadeva 有四个门徒， Vyasadeva 分别把这四个给了他们不同的四部经典给了他们不同的人。
Yeah. One is like the Vedic hymns, you know.We don't worry too much about what's in each of these four Vedas. It's not very significant for us.
我们并不去特别强调这个韦达经，因为它并不是对我们特别重要，就是说去了解这些细节。
We're more interested to...You should know that all the Vedic knowledge was summarized in the Vedanta. Veda means knowledge and anta means end. So Vedanta means the end of knowledge. So that's important for devotee.
我们经常提到的是 Vedanta. Veda 是知识， Danta 是终结，就是知识的终点，知识的终点，这个是奉献者在意的，知识的终点是什么。
And so the Vedanta knowledge is summarized in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
Vedanta 终极伟达经描述在圣典博伽瓦坛里面。
Yeah, the Srimad Bhagavatam is a commentary on the Vedanta.
而圣典博伽瓦坛是对韦丹塔终极韦达经的评注。
So we have also, we have, we see the Upanishads are also there in the Vedas. For example, we have the Ishopanishad. Ishopanishad is from the Yajur Veda.
我们有至尊奥义书，至尊奥义书是来自于亚洲维达。
Okay.
Here I have two more big questions. Next question from Harini, Dimbai Gurudev, Dimbai 所有聚会的奉献者，请问 Gurudev， 我有个弟弟原来是神经病，就跟我总过不去。后来有段时间念诵圣名的，头脑也清楚了，不找我的事了。可是后来又不念诵圣名的，去学基督了，现在也不学了。开始又见不得我了，我一回去看母亲，她家又开始骂我，不让我去我母亲家。请问这是不是我跟她的业报？这个业报，如果她不念诵圣名，我俩的业报是否可以消除？ Obeisances to Gurudev and all devotees. I have a brother, little brother.
Yes, Shenzhen Bing.
Yeah.
Mental problem.
Relationship not good. And But sometimes she chanted the holy name before, and the mind is also clear. But later, she go to the Jesus, and but later he also give up. Now he also speak some bad words to me, and don't let me to see my mother. So I want to know, is some karma between me and him?
Well, of course there's some karma between you and him. He's your brother, so there will be karma there.
I mean, all these things is show the our the karma reaction. Yes.
Yeah, it's his karma.
是的，这些是他的业报。 If he didn't chant the, he does not chant the holy name, how to remove this kind of karma between me and him?
Well, if he's not going to chant the holy name, if he's not going to become devotee, he's not going to chant the holy name, then you're not going to be able to get rid of the karma.
如果他不念诵圣名，如果他不成为奉献者，很难以摆脱掉这种业报。He
doesn't, you know, he doesn't listen to you. He doesn't want you to meet your mother, so that's not good.
他不听你的，然后不让你去见你的母亲，这也是不好。What
can you do to help him?
你能做什么呢？你帮助一下他。
Does he take, well, would he take help from you? Does he, and there's, he's not talking to you, he doesn't like you, he doesn't get along with you, he doesn't even let you see your mother. What can you do, you know?
他是否寻求你的帮助呢？但是他又不想跟你说话，又不想让你见你的母亲。 那我们能做什么呢?
You should go through your mother. You somehow you contact your mother by phone, and you speak to your mother and tell your mother what he's doing, and have your mother speak to him.
那你就绕过他跟你的母亲联系，你用手机跟你母亲打电话，告诉你的弟弟的所作所为，你希望直接见到你母亲。The
mother is the one to be able to deal with the son.
这个母亲能够和儿子去处理问题的。
You're the sister. He's not going to listen to you.
你只是他的姐姐，他并不一定会去听你。Better
you try to get the mother to talk to him.
最好让你的母亲直接跟他说。Next question. Next question also from Sumukhi Gopika Dasi. Obeisance to Maharaj. If, 请问一个植物被砍断之后，砍下的枝干又可以培养成另外一个植物。 植物里面的灵魂的数量是怎么计算的? Obeisance to Maharaj. If one plant are cut in two pieces, and one of these pieces we put into the earth, it become another plant. So how to cultivate how many souls in this new plant?
How many souls in the new plant?
Yeah.
Usually there's one soul in each plant.
But she said, because this plant is from one plant
tree.
Before.
But you can take that. You can take off the branch from the tree, and then you can put the branch into the ground, and it can start to grow. What happens is a soul enters into that branch.
OK. 这个是怎么样理解呢？当一个树的树枝被砍断，然后把这个树枝放到土里面，就它又长出另外一个，是这个灵魂进入到新的这一个树枝里面去了。
Yeah, the soul has to enter into the branch. Just like, you know, people want to have a child. It's not that everybody who, when the man and women, when the husband and wife unite, that every time they'll get a child. There has to be the sanction of the Supreme Lord, and he arranges for the soul to enter.
不是说那男性和女性每一天晚上就是每一天他们做这个活动的时候他就会有小孩，而首先应该是至尊主他先把灵魂注入到男性的 体内，通过他的精液然后生出小孩。
So birth comes about by the sanction of the Supreme Lord.
这个出生，这个灵魂是首先是被至尊主给注入进去的。
So you put the branch in the ground. It's not that every branch becomes a tree, but sometimes some branches will grow into a tree.
同样的，不是说你把一个树砍断之后，每一个树枝，就是每一个树枝它都插到土里就都能够成树，有一些是可以，那些都是至尊主注入的灵魂进去的。
Yeah, you have to have the right conditions to attract the soul to enter.
必须要有合适的环境去吸引恰当的灵魂进入到这个躯体之内。
And that goes on under the direction of the Supreme Lord.
这一切都是在至尊主的指导下去运作的。Okay, question no more. Hare Krishna, thank you.
Okay. So, woman, we thank Subhadi Rai Prabhu for his translation. I thank all the devotees for their listening and for their questions. And wish everyone happy Christmas. And take care, stay safe, stay healthy, and keep warm.
感谢所有的奉献者来聆听，希望大家这个平安夜，我希望大家圣诞节快乐，希望大家保持暖和，保持健康。
Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Jai, Hare Krishna.